Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain about our TCL TK based project named MCQ Checker. First of all, I would like to present my gratitude to PinE Training Academy for providing us hands-on training on TCL TK scripting language and their guidance to complete this project. Now, I would like to introduce my team members Apeksha Mishra, Nidhi Gupta, Priya Patel, Sakshi Kashyap, Tanay Kumar. Here are the content of our project, that are overview, command that we have used, flowchart, demo and the future modifications. Here is the overview. In our project there are two files. One file is containing the questions of MCQ type and one file is containing the answer. When user is going to mark the answer whatever he or she think is right, that answer is going to be get checked with the already saved answer sheet or the answer file. Here are the command that we have used, like radio button, that is used to implement a multiple choice button, which is a way to offer many possible selections to the user and lets user choose only one of them. Like you can see here in the image, there are two options, male and female, and out of those two, a customer or a user have to select any one. Another command is label, that is used to implement a display box where you can place text or images. Like here you can see that we have shown a one image there where you can see, hey, how are you doing? Next command is entry widget, that is used to accept a single line text string from a user. Like here, username, I can write whatever name I want to write. Other command is winfo, that returns window related information. My last command is list box widget, that is used to display a list of items. Like here, I am having a number of lists like Python, Perl and etc. So here is the final flow chart of our project. Like first we have to do registration, then login, then set of instructions going to get display, then we have to give the test, and lastly our answer sheet is going to be saved as a file somewhere. Now I will move to the demonstration of our project. For that I need to open Ubuntu. Here you can see the screen. For that I have to open my file with a wish interpreter, that is the interpreter of TCL. So here you can see the first very image of our project, that is home, and there are some menus like home, about us, registration, quick, quiz and contact us. When I'm clicking at home, this screen is going to come. When I'm clicking at about us, then information about PinE Training Academy is going to be get displayed, and the domain that you use, they used to offer. And when I'm clicking at registration, I'm going to get one registration form in which I have to fill number of entries like name and other. Like I have to fill it with a name. I'm writing a name, Priya Patel. If I'm submitting without giving any entry in the contact number, then that entry is going to get highlighted with a light pink color. And if now I'll show you, if I'm going to write a wrong number or more than 10 number, then it's going to be get highlighted with a dark pink color, which means that is a wrong number or with or that number is not in the range. So now I will fill my email ID @gmail.com. Now I will select any one of the domain that I want to choose. I will select ASIC verification. Now with the password, I have a set of instruction also to write a password. I'll show you, here is the set of requirement. You can see 8 character, special character, upper character, lower character, and at least one digit. Okay, so now I'm clicking at the registration form. So for the password, I'll write it. For the confirm password, that must be same. If I'm going to write something different, then it's going to get highlighted that it is not right, that it's not getting matched with the password. So for that, So here you can see one another window is going to get pop up with all the entries that I have filled with the name, contact number, email ID and domain. There are two options, back and final submit. If I want to change anything, then I can go, then I can click on back, and if I want to do a final submit, then just click on final submit, and you will get a unique ID with a unique ID number, that is PINE@4. After that, I have to click OK. Now I'm eligible to give any test series. So I'm going to click on that menu, and I have to fill my unique ID that I have got just right now. That was PINE@4. Now the password that I have given during my registration, login. So here you can see one another window with two menu, test series and exit, and a set of instruction. When I'm clicking at test series, there are number of test series from 1 to 5. I'm clicking at test series 1. This is a whole window, one timer and options, question, next and previous button, submit and cancel button. So here with the first question, I'm going to mark it with option A. With the second option is going to, I'm going to mark B. You can see the difference between the question that I have marked and unmarked. Like the two questions that I have marked that were highlighted with a green color, and the rest of question is still in a white color. With the second I have marked. For the third question, I'm going to mark A. For the fourth question, I'm going to mark B. For my fifth question, I'm going to mark D. You can see the time is going on. So sixth question, I'm going to mark B. For the seventh question, how many AND gates are required for a 1 to 8 multiplexer? For that, I'm going to mark C, that is 4. Other is 8, the IC, that is A. My next question is 9. For that, I'm how many 3 line to 8 line decoder? C. For the BCD to binary converter, I'm going to mark A. And for all this thing, so now I'm going to submit it, and it's still 17 seconds is left. So here you have done 12 questions out of 20. So now if you want to submit, yes. And here is the marks that I have got, 12. Okay, so the last menu is the contact. If you want to contact at the PINE Training Academy, you can contact with the contact number, or either you can go at the office. So here I would show you that at the home, whatever the file means, with the test record, that PINE@4, that test, that ID, unique ID that has given the result. Okay, so with the name, all the detail of the candidate and the marks that all the question that has been marked with the correct and not attempted also. That I have not attempted question number 11. Here it is. So, and I would like to tell you the future scope is like what we can implement in our project is the that forward password option and the sending marks through an email ID and the explanation of each question. If user want to get the explanation of that, how that question is going to get solved. Like that, and other modification also you can do that. And thank you so much for watching this video.